Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today's video, I'm going to teach you how to create more space on your timeline by going from this to this. This should make it easier navigating your timeline, especially if you work from a laptop as much as I do. So without wasting any more time, let's get into the tutorial. All right, so now we are in DaVinci Resolve, and as you can tell, my timeline is very, very small. So if you're looking for a way to get it a little bit wider, if you're working on a smaller screen or you just want the extra real estate, we're gonna show you how to do that real quick and easy. So you can go up to the very top left over your effects panel or media pool. This little icon right there looks like a little TV with legs. You're just gonna click that, and as you can tell, it extends it out all the way to the left. Now, you can also do the other side so that you can get that little bit of extra screen real estate. Over here in the inspector tab, you're gonna go up here, it's the exact same logo, little TV, it looks like it's got some legs or a stand. You're just gonna click that, and now you have the entire screen's width to work on your timeline. This will help if you have a smaller screen, like I said, or if you're working from a laptop on the road, like I do a lot. And if you're working on a bigger screen or a dual screen setup and you want to leave all that open, you're just going to click the small arrow button, bam, and the same thing on the top left. And then you got all your effects, and pull up your metadata or your mixer, which comes out to the left. And there you go. Those are a few quick tips, and I hope this gets you on the road to making your own content and getting it to the fullest of its potential. I hope you found value in this content and it helped you improve your skills a little bit more on the path to creating your own content. Leave any feedback in the comments below, as this helps us improve our content and overall makes our tutorials better for you. I would also like to ask you to smash the like button, as this helps us with the algorithm and ultimately will help push this tutorial to other people who may want to see this. So you'd be doing us a great favor. And if you enjoyed this and you want to see more videos like this, definitely consider subscribing to the channel. We'd love to have you as part of the community. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you next time.